All they want us to do is to continue to play your game, spend the money, be a good little puppet, be a good little player, and stay in your fucking lane.
Everybody, I wanted to make a kind of a short video to talk about something very specific right now with Black Desert Online, so we're gonna get serious for a second and we're gonna discuss
and he went full character mode and put on his mask.
All right, Zerodin. I'm ready.
Basically, the progression path of the game right now and how it's kind of killing the game.
Yep.
I know a lot of people have touched on this.
Oh, mask off, sorry. Okay.
Kind of briefly, and I wanted to really kind of take a moment and specify what our problems are and a potential fix. Obviously, right now, everything is going...
You're doing this wrong. You should have taken your entire script and then have it translated in Korean. This is a waste of 4 minutes and 20 seconds. What a time. What a literal pause. You're wasting your time at this point, bud.
Going towards the direction of Sovereign, Weapons, and Deborekas, which is fine. You know, that's the...
No, it's not fine. Don't brush it off. Stand on 2 feet right now, buddy. It's not fine. But go on.
Direction of the game. We've already kind of let the dogs loose, so there's no walking this one back. But the problem right now, and I think a lot of people are in the same boat, is that there is only one way to progress this stuff, and it's through Cronstones. It's through...
It's always been through Cronstones, bro.
Boy, you better get to a real good point here, buddy. We talk about Sovereign Weapons, we talk about the Devils, we talk about the Cronstones. Boy, you better backpedal right now, or I'm gonna have some shit to say.
Through Cronstones and Jay's Hammers, right?
Yeah.
But Jay's Hammers are going away. So what does that leave us with? Cronstones.
The same thing that we've always been doing. Go on.
Which is fine. I understand.
No, it's not fine.
And that you can use silver to buy cronstones. Mm-hmm. I got that. You can buy them right off the vendor. You can get costumes if you're lucky off the market. Got it. But my issue with the way the game is progressing, and I think a lot of us are in the same boat, is if you consider how progression works in this game, that be it that it needs cronstones to achieve pinnacle gear, mm-hmm. when you do pinnacle content, you should be getting something that is helping you progress that pinnacle gear.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, if cronstones are what you need to progress, or when you do pinnacle content, like mm-hmm. boss rushes or the guild boss rushes that just came out, or even Olin's, there should be dailies that are rewarding you with cronstones. There should be cronstone bundles that you're being rewarded out of those boxes. You should be getting cronstones in larger quantities from bosses. It shouldn't just be Kafir stones anymore. Because when Kafir was pinnacle content, we were having things that rewarded us with Kafir. Mm-hmm. Right now, there's only one way to get cronstones from the game for free that isn't like I'm going to grind in circles, and that is doing Pit of the Undying.
Yeah, Pit of Undying return for cronstones is terrible. You know, honestly, he does make a good point, because the game does trap you into stages where cronstones are now required to gear up. And to be quite frank with you, I'd have to agree. I think that is a little bit of a problem, because ain't no way you're going to craft 2 Pen Black Stars, get a Sovereign Weapon, and then having 10 levels of enhancement with such insanely low odds to click for. But the thing is, the option to buy them or through the vendor is there. Is it good? I don't think it's necessarily good. The problem that I have with this pinnacle gear, as he's labeling it as, is that there is no reason to obtain it. Even with Land of the Morning Light Part 2, the 5-man content, I mean, I'm able to do it. I've got 3 of my hard modes done, and I've got 2 more to do. And now going through the 5-man dungeon content, and we do 3 dungeons in less than an hour on hard mode. And on top of that, we've got the Black Shrine original content. It's just even easier now to do, and it's not that hard. The problem is that there's no insanely difficult content that compliments you for working towards such pinnacle gear, because there's no activity that matches the caliber of it. There is literally no point for going for 5-pen Devo set. There's no point for going for higher grade Sovereign Weapons, other than for the reason of just because. Now, while cronstones are the requirement and fuel for that, I don't necessarily see a problem with that. They do kind of trap you into using those and being the required material to enhance those. The more bigger problem that I have is that there's no content that matches the caliber of what you're working on. I am working towards these pieces of gear to go back to the same things I was already doing, but I'll be able to do it just a little bit faster. That's not good content. That's not good development. Not to mention, it's lazy development when we're getting spots rewarded to us or given to us, I should say, that is copy-pasted content that comes across as tremendously low effort. There's no game mode that is some new thing to look forward to towards working on this. There's no PvP content you can look forward to. A lot of it's capped. A lot of the things you go into are capped. It is just going to another grind spot to grind just a little bit faster towards working on minimalistic statistics for insanely large margins to get essentially nowhere. Running on a treadmill at this point would offer more progression than what this current system and state of its economy is offering right now.
A big part of the problem with BDO in general is that pinnacle content doesn't give us means to progress our pinnacle gear.
There, exactly what I just said. He gave you the short version, I said the long version of it.
Yes, we do have the ability to, you know, use our, like, what are those, the new stones that you get for a sovereign gear? That comes from...
Which are going to get min listed in a couple weeks. You just wait. They're going to be bottomed out. You just wait.
Content, that makes sense, right? Pinnacle content gets you pinnacle gear. But we need to have a way to introduce more Kron stones into the game that isn't just either grinding in circles or buying them off the market, buying them off a vendor. It shouldn't be the only way. I think if there was Kron stones being rewarded from our PvP content, even if you're just doing AOS and you're getting like decent Kron stones per hour.
To be honest, he's kind of cooking here. This is pretty based. Because if you think about the time of Kafras, when Kafras had first come out and even people were working on getting C9, C10, pushing upwards of even C20, daily quests were something that people did on the regular basis. Going through a lot of Comma Sylvia content, going through a lot of different node managers that had Kafras in its daily reward system and running those daily quests was a very min-max and efficient thing to be doing throughout your day. Because the value that it gave you in return for its current state in the marketplace actually yielded incredibly good return for the time that you invested into it. Nowadays, there's really not too much daily content that is worthwhile doing that quite truly complements the things that you're progressively working on into the later game. There's almost nothing.
You can buy a Kron bundle. That'd be great. There'd be a way outside of spending real dollars to kind of get ahead.
That's not what they want, though. Let's be clear, though. They don't want to be taking away business from a huge moneymaker, which is indeed the costumes. But I definitely think that there needs to be value towards doing certain things on a regular basis and daily basis that absolutely complements your progression in this game in maximum efficiency, other than just loading up, getting your buffs ready, and going to some tower spot to sit on it and let the waves come on in.
I'm fine with them having their pearl shop being monetized the way it is, but I'm not fine with Kron stones being the only form of progression and then us not having a meaningful way to attain Kron stones other than a raw silver purchase. There's also the other point that buying Kron stones off the vendor doesn't feel rewarding. It doesn't feel good for the content that you're doing to be rewarded by just buy them off of the vendor. It doesn't feel good to just buy them off the marketplace in a costume and then melt that costume down. It diminishes the value of that activity. It makes it feel less rewarding. There's not as much of a dopamine in it.
It feels real good when it goes, doesn't it? You buy those vendor crons, it finally goes, then it feels good, doesn't it? How many J hammers did you spend on that necklace there, Zerodin? Are you butthurt over how hard that necklace was to work on? But I do agree. All jokes aside, I do agree. There needs to be more passionate meaning towards working on certain things and doing these certain things. And to be quite frank with you, I'm upset that you took your mask off because now I'm taking you less seriously.
Out a bundle out of doing a boss, and then you open that bundle, you get a ton of cron stones, yep. And it helps you with your progression. That feels good.
I mean, they have the Shikadu scam boxes if you really, really wanted to work towards those.
So food for thought. I feel like this might be a good way for us to kind of get PA's attention and how to help progress our game.
And no, not at all. I hate, you know, look, Zerodin, I love you, but sadly it's not. I know your heart's in the right place and I know you're really trying to put something out there that you think is a meaningful idea, but a lot of us have put out meaningful ideas with even more detail and depth put into it with even more volume back behind it. And sadly, my friend, it's not. It's just not. They're going to hear this and it's going to be completely brushed aside. I hope that's not the case, obviously, because I want what's best, but you know, having any hopes that PA is going to genuinely listen to us, hear us, and make a positive change that's going to help the direction of this game, it's not going to happen. In my personal opinion, I think the only thing that's going to help is competition. Oh my God, thrown in Liberty. I don't need to hear it right now. I don't give a about this Throne and Liberty shit coming out, yes, I'm gonna play it. Unless people jump on the Throne and Liberty bandwagon and it actually holds up for a good period of time, then we might start seeing positive changes in a direction that we need to, because PA is going to be in shambles trying to get their business back, especially a lot of their creators. But Throne and Liberty could also be a phase where people just see something new coming out. PA is probably just gonna come out with a fucking drop event like they normally do, and then people are gonna play it for a little while, they'll get sick of it, and they'll come back to BDO, and then they're gonna go, wow, this game is better than this one that we played, and then life's just gonna continue to go on. Obviously, I don't want that to happen. We need competition that actually puts up a good fight with these developers, because what it does is it forces them to actually start making these changes and forces them to start listening to the changes that we want to actually have happen. Unless they don't have competition amongst them that is driving them to make these changes, simply just expressing our opinions and our voices will just not be enough. It simply will just never be enough. Even if it is a good idea and a grand idea, it's just not enough. That's how I feel.
Not just make it like, oh, you know, the game is awful and everything's bad.
This man literally just pressed a button to make his avatar cross his arms. I love it. Now I'm taking you seriously. Now put the mask back on.
Everything's bad. It's fine to have problems, right? We need to identify problems as a community. But what's better than identifying the problems is bringing a solution to the table. So that,
yeah, like everyone has been doing. How many times have people gone out of their way to complain, offer solutions, etc., etc., criticize? These things will not happen unless we have positive competition that drives the changes that have to happen. I'm not allowed to leak the conversations of the partner Discord, but the BDO partners, I cannot begin to tell you the amount of ideas that I have seen suggested from even our largest creators abroad with very, very good reasons as to the who, what, when, where, how, why. And the amount of times those suggestions and ideas just get pushed up and then fade into fucking nothing because everyone is just starting to complain about AFK streamers or talk about this or talk about that. Or, oh my God, sign up for this new costume. And then, oh my God, how was your day? No. They do not listen. They don't. And the people who take this feedback and deliver it to whoever needs to hear it, they don't listen. They don't listen in the way that we want them to hear us. All they want us to do is to continue to play your game, spend the money, be a good little puppet, be a good little player, and stay in your fucking lane. That's what they want. And I don't want this game to fail. I want amazing things to happen for this game and flourish into a beautiful thing that I honestly think that it can do and be. But it's just not going to happen just because we have an opinion. It's just simply not enough. It's never enough. And I don't think this is a language barrier thing. I don't think this is an English or Korean thing. Even Korea is starting to have very similar issues as to what we are having and experiencing. So while I do think the topic itself is good and the statement is fine and your offering of a solution is honestly pretty watered down because there could be more off of it, the conversation is important to have. I just think that our opinion and our voices just isn't enough. Even no matter how loud it goes and how far it reaches, I think the changes will not happen unless competition starts actually targeting things that matter to them, and it's going to be their pockets. It's going to be money. If they start losing out on business, they're going to start making changes that drive their business to a more successful place. But based on the updates that we're seeing, I agree. It's like a wolf howling to the moon.
That is one solution option, and I'd like to hear if you guys have more. So if you have more, please put them in the comments. I plan to send this video to Perlipus to see what they have to say about the subject matter and see if maybe we can get some new content added to the game that will help us progress Pinnacle content.
It's not going to happen, dude. Not going to happen. I know you sent this to me 10 minutes even after you uploaded this, and I'm checking it out now a couple days later. I think your heart is in the right place, but I think the people that it needs to be in front of, well, this will never be shown to. This conversation will never be had around them.
Thank you guys, as always, for being here and supporting the channel. If you haven't already, I'm like kind of like a newer creator on the YouTube sphere. Do me a huge favor and just like and follow.
Like, follow, comment. You know, I think Zerodin does a really good job keeping a level head and trying to keep other people's best interests in mind and things like that. But, you know, I love you, buddy, but I hate to say it, but my genuine opinion is I don't think this is going to get anywhere.